Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, 'cause Jesus is the way. I know you got questions in the corners of your mind, traces of discouragement and peace you cannot find. Reflections of your old past, they seem to face you every day. This one thing I know for sure is Jesus is the way. Y'all know this song, sing it with me. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, 'cause Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Amen. Above him there's no other, 'cause Jesus is the way. Now I know you got mountains that you think you cannot climb. You say your skies are dark and you think the sun won't shine. Well, in case you don't know, I'm here to tell you that the word of God is true. And everything is promised, I know he will do it for you. Stand up and sing it with me now. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, it's Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer, sing it again. Jesus is for the world. Above him there's no other, it's Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Sing it again, y'all. Jesus is the way. One more time. Jesus is the way. Amen. Questions in the corners of your mind, traces of discouragement and peace you cannot find. Reflections of your old past, they seem to face you every day. This one thing I know for sure is Jesus is the way. Y'all know this song, sing it with me. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, 'cause Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Amen. Above him there's no other, 'cause Jesus is the way. I know you got mountains that you think you cannot climb. You say your skies are dark and you think the sun won't shine. Well, in case you don't know, I'm here to tell you that the word of God is true. And everything is promised, I know he will do it for you.
here with me now.
Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. It's Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer. Sing it again. Jesus is for the world. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Sing it again, y'all. Jesus is the way. One more time. Jesus is the way. Amen. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. I know you got questions in the corners of your mind, traces of discouragement and peace you cannot find. Reflections of your old past, they seem to face you every day. This one thing I know for sure is Jesus is the way. Y'all know this song, sing it with me. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Amen. Above him there's no other. 'Cause Jesus is the way. I know you got mountains that you think you cannot climb. You say your skies are dark and you think the sun won't shine. Well, in case you don't know, I'm here to tell you that the word of God is true and everything is promised. I know he will do it for you. Stand up and sing it with me now. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. It's Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer. Sing it again. Jesus is for the world. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Sing it again, y'all. Jesus is the way. One more time. Jesus is the way. Amen.
Our Father, we thank you for this morning that you have made. Thank you for waking us up and giving us grace to come into your presence. Be exalted, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask that you speak to us yourself. Help us, O Lord God, with your great help. The Bible says when you helped Uzziah and he was marvelously helped, he became very successful. Your help has value to us. We ask, O God, that you give us insight. hindsight and foresight, and cause your word to do us good today in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. We want to thank God for bringing us to today's Sunday service. Everyone joining us online, the Lord God Almighty bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare and decree that His will be done in your life. You will not be a victim. You will never be a victim. You will not be a victim of anything that is going on earth negatively in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare you protected by Jehovah. You are protected by the Almighty God in the name of Jesus Christ. His grace will be sufficient for you. His strength to be perfected in your weakness in the name of Jesus Christ. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Now, this morning, I'll be teaching on the topic, living a prophesied life. Living a prophesied life. Living a prophesied life. Psalm chapter 40, verse number 7. Psalm 40, verse number 7. The Bible says, "Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me. Lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me." The same scripture was repeated in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 7. Hebrews chapter number 10, verse 7. The Bible says, "Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book. It is written of me to do thy will, O God." It is written of me to do your will, O God. Everyone listening to me, listen carefully. I want to pull out something very dangerous here. I have discovered on earth that everything you do each day is a product of something that is prophesied. Whether it is good or bad, I discovered that everyone have different books written concerning them. And the book you choose to read or to act from determines your actions. Everyone have a minimum of two books written concerning him or her. The book you choose to act from determines your actions. The book you decide to act from. There are forces pushing you to act in a particular way. Other forces pushing you to act in a particular way. It is the choice you make after developing yourself and making yourself strong internally in your heart, in your spirit, man. The action you finally submit to is what is prophesied concerning you. We live each day a prophesied life. We live each day a prophesied life. I'm coming. You see something. Acts chapter 4, verse number 23 to verse 28. Acts 4, 23 to 28 says, "And being let go, they went to their own company and reported all that the chief priests and elders had said unto them. And when they heard that, they lifted up their voice to God with one accord and said, Lord, thou art God which hath made the heaven and the earth and the sea and all that in them is, who by the mouth of thy servant David have said, why did the heathen rage and the people imagine vain things? The kings of the earth stood up and the rulers are gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. For of a truth, against thy holy child Jesus, whom thou hast anointed both Herod and Pontius Pilate with the Gentiles and the people of Israel were gathered together." Verse 28 is very important. "For to do whatsoever thy hand and thy counsel determined before to be done." "For to do whatsoever your hand and your counsel have determined to be done before." Everything that happened to Jesus was already predetermined. Was already predetermined. So it is what the hand of God had predetermined that should happen, that happened to Jesus Christ. Now, you might ask me, how come they sold him? Wasn't he supposed to be the Messiah? Now, what happened on earth was, it was a choice. They chose to kill him. They decided to play from another script because everyone has a minimum of two books written concerning him. the negative and the positive. It is where you choose to act from that you start acting. Many times people are a blend of the two. They act from here and they act from there. They act from here and they act from there. And while you are switching acting, that is what stains your life. Everything you are doing is prophesied. Everything you are doing is already prophesied. And then there are times that other people around you give voice to the prophetic word about your life. They come to give voice to it. They look at you and they speak. Somebody must have said, this, our family does not prosper. And you believe it. You start acting it and you stop prospering. Our family don't live long and you believe it. People start dying in that family. Why? Because it is what is prophesied. Each day you live a prophesied life. Each day you live a prophesied life. That is why you need to study the scriptures to know what is prophesied, what is written in the volume of the books positively concerning you, so you can act exactly like that. That's why you need to read the scriptures. If you do not read the scriptures, there are other books written concerning you. You just find yourself displayed in a certain way. Judas went to sell Jesus, not just because he sold Jesus or because of the wicked man, but because it is according to what was determined to be done before. It's a pity he decided to be the one that will act that part of the action. There were other disciples also. They never chose to act that the part. Peter was there. Do you know, the devil have already chosen Peter and wanted Peter to act that part, but Peter refused. Why? Because he was so connected to Jesus that Jesus prayed for him and he didn't act that part. So finally, this man called Judas was available to act that part, and they positioned him very well, gave him some character that made it easy for him to act that part, and acted it. It's a pity that he didn't make it to heaven. It's a pity he never made it to heaven. Because he acted that part, it destroyed all that he had labored for. See, everyone is acting a script. You are acting a script. Be careful the script you are acting from. Be careful. Again, Revelation chapter 20 from verse 11 to 12, you will see something there very powerful in the scripture. Very powerful in the Bible. The Bible says, "And I saw a great white throne, and him that sat on it, from whose face the earth and the heavens fled." Revelation chapter 20, verse 11, now that's where we are. The Bible says, "And there was found no place for them." Verse 12, my emphasis. "And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened. And another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of the things, those things which were written in the books, according to their works." Watch me. I want to. The Bible says, the books were opened. That's why I said, watch me. And another book was opened. So there are books. And then there's a book. There are books. I saw it here. And then a book. So which book are you acting from? Is it the book of life or the books? Is it the book of life or the books? You are living a life that is already scripted. The problem is, who is the one you are following? Whose script are you following? Each day you misbehave, it is a script. You are obeying something. Each day you do well is a script. God has predestined you to do well. If you choose to follow that script, you'll be doing well. If you also choose, the devil has also written some books concerning you. Witches have written some books concerning you. Agents of the devil have written some books concerning you. The curses of your fathers have written some books concerning you. Demons have written some books concerning you. Those that do not want your destiny to prosper have written some books concerning you. Is the book you choose to act from? So which book are you acting from? Which book? You know, when I came to this realization just recently, I began to wonder, which book am I really acting from? Which book am I acting from? I'm telling you. I began to wonder, where am I really in this? What am I doing? What am I? You need to be careful where you're acting from. If you don't know where you're acting from, you can be acting from the books. You don't mind yourself doing what they wrote in the books. Everyone on earth is acting a script. I repeat, everyone is acting a script. Do you know that there are scripts written for nations that people in this nation will be very unfaithful? Let you see all of them in that nation become very unfaithful. Look at Sodom and Gomorrah. A script was written concerning them that they are going to be very deceptive and very promiscuous. And excuse me, sir, in the whole world, in that generation, Sodom and Gomorrah were acting that script in a bad way, in a very serious way. That angel came to visit them. They wanted to arrest the angel, to rape the angel. Angels, two angels came. They were acting that script with anger. The Bible said they even came to the door and they were knocking the house of this guy called Lot. I said, bring them out. Oh, Lord, Jere, we want to know them. We want to manifest with them. They were acting the script with anger. The books were open. And another book was open. You are acting a script. Whenever you behave anyhow, check, where am I acting from, self? Who wrote the script? The script that I'm acting from. Who am I representing here? You know, many times I look at myself when I stand, I say, this must be this way. And then I check myself, where am I acting from? Oh, this is how God has. Oh, wonderful. The devil tries to push me to act the way. Then I ask myself, where am I acting from? Always ask yourself, where am I acting from? You are acting from a script. There are books. The Bible said they will check the book. Let us read again. I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God, and the books were opened. Very good. And another book was opened, which is the book of life. Now listen carefully. It said, and the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. Apart from that, they are recording what you have done. There is already a script written. So God will compare the script and what you did. We wrote in the book that you should do this. This was what you did. So where did he do it from? They will check the books. Oh, the book of armed robbery. The book of foolishness. Because they are all books. Everyone is acting from a book. That is why you need to now be conscious of what you are doing. As you keep growing up and becoming wiser in life, I'm conscious of what you are doing. Check it yourself. Am I acting from the book of life or am I acting from the books? Now let me show you something. The Bible says in Romans chapter 9 verse 17. Romans 9 17 says, for the scripture saith Pharaoh, even for this same purpose have I raised him up, that I might show my power in thee, and that my name might be declared throughout all the earth. Eh? Excuse me, sir. They said they gave back to Pharaoh to display God's power negatively. to finish him in the Red Sea so that fishes can eat him up in order to prove that God is powerful. Now listen, there were two power players there in the days of Pharaoh, Moses and Pharaoh. Moses was displaying the power of God positively, was a carrier of the power of God, while Pharaoh was a recipient negatively. They were using the power to flog him. So the Bible said they created Pharaoh. The script written concerning Pharaoh is that he's going to be stubborn until he's destroyed by the power of God, so that everybody will know that God is very powerful. So they made him very stubborn, added stubbornness to his genealogy, wrote it in the books, and then he began to act it. He said, I'm not going to let Israel go. Just so that God can wound him, I will not allow Israel to go. And he kept on becoming stubborn and stubborn until finally he pursued them into the Red Sea. And God said, yeah, let the Red Sea swallow him. And they crossed him. Because when people heard all over the world, they were afraid of Israel. And they said, their God is powerful. The Bible said, God said, I raised up Pharaoh just to show that I'm very powerful. Chai, what is script? What is script? You know, many times, things happen to me when people behave somehow to me, and I connect myself, Father. Then as I conclude, probably that's the script written concerning them. Father, help me to behave well so that I don't find myself at the other side of life. In fact, anything anyone is doing around you is a script. The person is following is a script. So what you need to do is connect yourself to divine script so that you do not find yourself in a demonic book displaying what they wrote there, sir. And so again, in Romans chapter 9, verse number 22 to 23, Lord, help me act the prophecy that you wrote concerning me. I refuse to act demonic prophecy in the name of Jesus Christ. I refuse to display what is written in the books. I receive grace to act on what is written in the book of life. Help me, oh God. Help me from today. Help me to align myself, oh God, to always act according to what is written in the book, not what is written in the books, oh God. Verse 22 to 23, the Bible says, what if God, willing to show his anger, his wrath, and to make his power known, endued with much long-suffering the vessel of wrath, vessel of anger, fitted to destruction. Verse 23 says, and that he might make known the riches of his glory on the vessel of mercy, which he had afore prepared unto glory. So there are two vessels there. Vessel unto wrath, fitted, organized, arranged, fitted for destruction. Another one, vessel unto of mercy, prepared unto glory. My God, my God. The Bible says God did it afore, before you were born, sir. So why don't you connect yourself to the positive script and begin to follow that? I make up my mind. Everyone hearing me, in the name of Jesus, receive grace to begin to follow the positive script and not display or walk or act the negative script. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, some people are vessels of mercy, prepared unto glory, while some are vessels of wrath, fitted for destruction, sir. Hallelujah, praise God. Okay. Do you know that when pencil was created, eraser was also created? So some people's destiny is to act as pencil, while some is to act as eraser. I'm telling you, sir. When building cranes were created, caterpillars to destroy were also created. So some people are to act as building cranes to lift up buildings and make the buildings fantastic, while others are created as caterpillars to pull them down. The Bible says some are vessels of mercy, prepared unto glory, while some are vessels of wrath, prepared, fitted. That one is serious. Fitted to be wrought, creating destruction everywhere they go to. They create destruction. They destroy things. They don't make things work. It will never be your portion. It will never be your destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, it will never. The young man that used to be around us some time ago, many years ago, when we were in church, anything he touches will have problem. Anything. At some point, they began to tell him, don't touch the keyboard again. Please don't go near the drum. No, he had one in seven. The place he does, because if he touches it. Now, the guy has a good heart. He likes fixing things. If you see the keyboard not working, he will want to make it work. While trying to make it work, it will break the man tear. When the speaker he want to fix it, the next thing, he will open it. While opening it, the speaker will tear. Every time he tries to do something, it ends up, so people want him, please, we know you love fixing things, but please don't fix again. We don't want you near the speaker because it's very expensive. We don't want you near the keyboard. They banned him from many things. Why? Because they noticed that there's something. There's a script that is overshadowing his heart desire and forcing itself to be displayed through him. Watch it. What script are you acting from? What script are you acting from? Jeremiah chapter number 1 from verse 4 to 5. Everyone is living a prophesied life. If you are a thief, you are following a script as a thief. It's a prophecy coming to pass in your life that you'll be a thief according to the books. If a witch is also prophesied, it's a script written that you are going to be a witch. And then if you're so great, doing well, serving God, it's also a script you're obeying. Choose this day who you want to serve. Choose where you want to be. Today that God is opening your eyes, deliberately follow the right script. Make up your mind, I will do the right thing. I have made up my mind. I discovered that. So that's how life is. It's what you determine that you see yourself achieving. If you don't make plans, Many things I've already planned for you. I repeat, if you don't make plans, many things have failure has planned for you. Shame has planned for you. Poverty has planned for you. Disgrace has planned for you. All of them have room for you. They want to accommodate you. It is time for you to make plans to follow God and disconnect from every demonic plan. Make up your mind you will not fulfill demonic plans in the name of Jesus Christ. No matter what is happening to you, you can determine. I have seen people in difficult and hard situations, but they make up their mind to obey God, and God honors them. I made up my mind by the grace of God. I will serve the script of the Almighty. Since all the books are open, I will follow the Almighty script in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I have made up my mind. See, God gave us the power of choice. Choose you this day who you will serve. Choose what you want. God gave us the power of choice. So you can choose to fulfill the script of the Almighty. You can also fulfill the script of the devil, whichever one you choose. Life is scripted. Jeremiah chapter 1. Very good. From verse 4 to 5. Jeremiah chapter 1, 4 to 5. Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations. Look at it. When did they arrange this guy's destiny? Before he was born. I am proving it to you here. Before he was born. If you read the story of Cyrus, before Cyrus was born, close to 100 or so years before Cyrus was born, a prophecy already came for Cyrus that is going to be the one that will build the temple. A prophecy already came. How did they know it? You are already predestined. There is a script you are playing on earth. If you're a wicked man, you are playing a script. If you're a good man, you're playing a script. But I discovered that you can choose the script you play from. You can choose it. Despite the fact that are forced pulling you everywhere, forcing you to do some things, you can choose the script. I made up my mind, I will play from the script of the Almighty God. I will act from that script. I will not disappoint heaven. Okay. See, there are opportunities for everybody to sin. One day, one guy came and said he fell into sin because he was tempted, and then this and that. Another person said, shut up, excuse me, all of us are so tempted. The same lady, saw the lady too. We and hold our traps are tight. So don't try to pretend as if the devil has sat on your neck. Now, it's a choice. You made that choice. You took that path. You allowed the devil to cajole you to that path. God has given you strong will to make a choice. Make his grace be available for you so that you make the right choice in the name of Jesus Christ. He says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. Eh? He already know the baby before the baby was formed. So where was the baby? It was somewhere before. He says, before you came forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. Wonderful. And I already ordained you from the womb to be a prophet of the nation. So when you came out, you started playing the scripts. You started prophesying. And people say, that guy is a good prophet. Oh, he's anointed. It's already loaded into his DNA. It was already written in the books. Now, watch Jesus. The Bible says to us, when Jesus stood before the devil said, turn these stones to become bread. The devil was trying to switch Jesus to the books. But Jesus said, no. He was audacious enough and strong in mind. His emotions were balanced enough. He was not deceived. He stood and told him, man shall not live alone, but every word that proceeded out of the mouth of the Lord. He was strong enough to take him back to the original script. Hallelujah. So no wait, excuse me, devil. And then he said, I will give you the whole world if you fall. He said, stop that there, for it is written, you must worship the Lord your God, and only him shall you serve. He said, I will do this. He said, he gave him the thought. He kept on giving it to him according to what is written concerning it. You need to know what is written concerning. That's why you need to study the scriptures, obey the scriptures, so that such things that is written concerning you will be what you are displaying, either knowingly or unknowingly. You are following the scripture. You are following the script. See, do you know that? There could be a script written concerning a man and said, your wife will be nice in the book of life,
Another scripture, your wife will be wicked, and then he marries a woman, and then the woman is nice. Then later the woman becomes wicked. Then later she changes, the guy becomes nice. You are acting the script. What you are doing, you are juggling in between the two. Jumping up and down. Translate, you are here, you are there, you are here. Now listen, Judas Iscariot must have been a good person for Jesus to make him his treasurer. Judas must have been a good person. But the problem was that somebody was supposed to act the script. And the devil was checking who among the scripts. We need somebody very authentic, somebody very serious. So when they applied for Peter, Jesus said, no, I've prayed for you. For the devil has desired to have you. No, you can't. I don't want you to. Because of the way Peter brought revelation about Jesus. Because of Peter's dedication, Peter's service to God. God looked into the future. No, Peter will be very useful. He said, no, I will not allow this to happen to Peter. So he didn't allow Peter to be sieved like wheat. But Judas, I have already developed some characters that made it easy for him to act that script. He was a member of the Church of the Pharisees. He was also a member of the Church of Jesus Christ. In fact, he was a treasurer. You know, he commands everybody to bring the account and show. Come on. Say, what much did you spend? Yeah, Peter, line up here. Jude, where are you? How much did you pay for the paper? You, did you do photocopy? No, you are telling lies. How much is the camera? So all of them will line up. He was the church auditor. So, because of the way he behaved, people believed that he believed in the ministry of Jesus. And then he was promoted to become the treasurer. Now, the devil began to look, who do I use? Since Jesus has blocked me from using Peter. Who else? This guy has a character that we can use. The way he behaves, he comes to the Pharisees' church, he even gossips about Jesus Christ. We can use him. Because we need this script acted. Who will sell him? And then the Bible says he was greedy. Greed began to rise in him. Then indignation. He started getting angry. Whenever Jesus talking, he will ask. Say, Jesus, be very careful here. He kept on. Until one day he did it in public. The Bible says somebody broke an alabaster bowl, bazaar, carried the oil and poured on Jesus. He spoke with indignation, not just anger. He stood up and said, excuse me, why are we wasting all this here? I'm the treasurer of the movement. If we sell this, we'll have enough money to give the poor and also to do more crusades. The Bible says he did not say that because he loved crusade or because he loved the poor, but because he was a thief. Then they gave him that script to act. The devil entered him and shifted him from his original destiny, which was for him to be one of the foundations of the New Jerusalem. Shifted him, moved him to act another script, and which is to sell Jesus. When he sold Jesus, he realized that he was acting a bad script. The Bible says he returned back and cried and said, I didn't plan to sell this man. Well, what did you guys do to me? And what happened here? It was already late. He has already acted. The Bible says he carried the money they gave him and gave them and threw it in the temple and went out. The people said they went to use it to buy land for him. And the Bible says he got there and he hung himself. It was already late. He has already acted that script. How I wish he switched back to the original script that God created for him. He could not switch back to that script, and then it was late for him. The devil have already entered him. Be careful the script you are acting from. You are living a prophesied life. If you're unfaithful, this is script you're acting. You're acting from the books. If you are faithful, this is script you're acting. You're acting from the book of life written concerning you. Let's go a little bit more so you can understand more things. Ephesians chapter 1, from verse 11 to 12. Ephesians chapter 1, from verse 11 to 12. The Bible says, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will, that we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ. That we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ. Listen again, verse 11, in whom we also have obtained an inheritance, having predestined according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his will. We are predestined according to purpose. And the purposes are written in either the book or the books. Every child of God, yours is written in the book of life. Everybody has the book of life. But there are also books written to corrupt your destiny, to scatter it, to make you misbehave. And all the books are begging for expression. They want you to express what is written. That is why whenever any dead stands, the books will be opened. Then another book will be opened to check where you acted from part time. See, it's like a film that people are doing. You know, when you act small here and they cut, you act a little here, they cut. You act a little here, they cut. Then finally they will join it together, it will become a movie. Am I right? That's the way it happens. They will join all the acts together, it becomes a movie. So the movie, they will now begin to check, where did he act from? In this angle, he stole. He acted from the book of stealing. In this place, he was angry, acted from the book of anger. This place, he worshipped, he acted from the book of life. They check where you acted from. By the time the entire movie is pieced together, we will know where you belong. Whether you belong to God or you belong to the devil. Why? Where you acted from and consistently acted from determines where you go to. And also, where you acted from and the end came and met you there determines where you go to. Because the Bible says if a good man does so much good and then before he dies, he did one bad thing. Every good he had done will be forgotten. Only the bad he did will be presented. So also, if a bad person does a lot of wickedness, and then before he dies, he does good, and then he switches, gives his life to Christ, and does something good. That's it. All the good he had, all the bad he had done will be forgotten, and that good he did will open his door. That is why, many times, it is dangerous to allow a witch to live, because if the witch lives and kills you, destroys your life, and finally gives his life to Christ, 2 minutes to the witch will be in heaven. Will be in heaven. You might even go to hell because the witch wounded you badly. You cried, you cursed, you misbehaved, you even acted from the devil's script before you died. Hallelujah. That's why they suffer not a witch to live. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's get a little more. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse number 19 to 21. You are acting a script. Check yourself. Where are you acting from? Are you acting from the book of life or you're acting from all the books? 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19 to 21. Nevertheless, the foundation of God is sure, having this seal. God knows that are his, and everyone that named the name of Christ depart from iniquity. But in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also wood. Now my emphasis. Some to honor and some to dishonor. The Bible says in verse 21, if a man therefore purge himself this, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified for the master's use, prepared of every good work. Now watch it. Some to honor, some to dishonor. What vessel are you? Are you a vessel unto honor, a vessel unto dishonor? Are you acting the script to bring honor to the kingdom of God, to the house of God, to the glory of God, or you are acting the script to bring dishonor, pain, shame, disgrace, trouble to the house of God, to the name of God? What actions are you taking? They are all in the same house. He said in the great house, there are not only vessels of gold, but all of them are in the same house, vessels of wood, in the same house, the vessels to honor, vessels to dishonor, in the same house, not in a different house. Not in a different house. Hallelujah. The Bible says, if a man therefore himself from this, he shall be a vessel unto God. Therefore, it means there are things you can work on by yourself. Purge yourself. Ask God to remove this and that from you, and then you become a vessel unto God. See there. If a man therefore purge himself from the things that makes him to be of dishonor, he shall be a vessel unto honor, made for the master's use, prepared unto good, not bad works. But if he decides not to pass through purging, he will remain a vessel unto dishonor, helping to act the script written by the devil and his cohorts until he finally acts in remaining in the hellfire or in the lake of fire. If a man purge himself of this, whenever you see yourself acting in a way that you think is not written in the book of life, ask for purging. That's what I do to myself. Ask your father, please purge me. Punch me, what am I doing? Is this what I'm supposed to be doing, Matt? No, this is not my destiny. Punch me, oh God. Punch me. If a man purge himself from this, he will turn to a vessel unto honor. He was formerly a vessel unto dishonor. But if he purge himself from this, Father, please purge me from this. All the things called this, things that corrupt, things that make me to act in a dishonorable way to your glory. Lord, I'm asking that you purge me from this. can be sanctified.
Meat for the master's use, not for the devil's use. Prepared unto every good work, not unto stupid works.
Hallelujah, praise God. So you can be purged, and by that you start acting from a divine script. All right, let's go. Luke 22, from verse 31 to 32. Luke chapter number 22, from verse 31 to 32. I want to show you something. Child, this word is sweet today. Hallelujah. Which script are you acting from? Always ask yourself, which script am I acting from now? Now that I've just messed up now, or whatever I've done. Which script? You know, many times people do wrong thing and they justify it. Say, I didn't do anything wrong. I didn't. It's fine. Ask yourself, where did I act wrong? It will help you better. Many people, their consciences are seared with hot iron. When they do bad things, they don't even feel bad at all. But ask yourself, which script am I acting from? Devil script or God script? From the book of life or from the books? Let's go. Luke 22, 31 to 32. The Bible says, in Luke 22, 31 to 36, and the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan have desired to have you so you can act the script. I see your Bible. Simon, Simon, behold, Satan have desired to have you. Now listen, he was not with Satan before. He was with Christ fully. But Satan desired to have him. Peter, you can fit this script. I like this guy. If I arrest this guy and employ him and hire him to add the script, he will act very well. He will serve Jesus very quickly. he might he will even be ringing the bell. Back out for sale. Jesus for sale. Back out Jesus for sale. The devil calculated, if I catch this guy to act, he will act it well. And so he desired him. You know, Peter knows how to do gra-gra. Peter, the other day Jesus said, to die and then I'll leave this world. Hey, Peter says, stop that, you man. What kind of nonsense are you telling us? Far be it from you. And all of us left everything and we're following you and you're telling us you're going to die. What kind of death? If I hear you say that, if I hold your mouth like this. When the devil saw him, say, child, this guy can't act him. He's a good actor. Jesus now looked at Peter and said, get thee behind me, Satan. Oh, Satan said, you see now, I can enter this guy and quickly use this guy. The rehearsal he did, he passed the audition. This guy has passed the audition very well. Let us now involve him in this movement to destroy Jesus. The Bible says, Jesus said, no. Look at it there. The Bible says, but I have prayed for thee that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. Ah, so that means the guy was not converted. God said, when you are converted, because the devil has planted that seed already. No wonder he still denied Jesus.
Do you know him? Say, what did he say? G what? I've never heard his name before. A house help. The devil knows how to humiliate someone. Brought a house help, not even an important human being. House help that they are paying 3,000 shillings. Showed up. I know this guy. Whenever Jesus follows my auntie to the house, this guy always carried his bag. Peter said, what did you say? I don't know what you're talking about. The guy whom Peter cut off his ear also kept saying, he cut my ear. Look at Peter said, I started cursing. He said, you are cursed. If I know Jesus, let me die. If I let caterpillar kill me for Jesus. Because the seed was already planted for him to act that part. He was supposed to have sold Jesus, but God said no. When you are converted, that will not happen. When he saw that, what? So I am caught in between his web. He returned back to the original script and started crying. He cried. You know, after crying, the devil still wanted him to act negatively. When Jesus finally died and went to heaven, Peter went to the tomb, saw that Jesus had resurrected. The devil was still pulling him to act that part. They were telling him, many good things are waiting for you. Come and act this part for us. There's a negative part you need to act from the books. We want you to act it. God had already written that Peter was going to be the bishop of the church. And God wanted Peter to act that part. But the devil also wanted him to act another part. So they pulled him until one day he got up and told the rest of the devils, I go a fishing. I am returning back to my vomit. I am going back to where I came from. The church I came from, if I want to go back there. I want to stop all this holiness movement. Oh, Jerry, and this righteousness and all that. Please excuse me, guys. I am going back to fishing. I am no more a fisher of men. I am going back to be a fisher man. Simple. The Bible says close to 7 of his disciples, of the devil of Jesus, followed him. In fact, this time, when he went out fishing, he removed his jacket. He removed his trousers. He was not wearing clothes anymore. he returned back to fishing fully. And that night, again, he started fishing. And then there was a tussle between him and the script of the devil and the script of God in his life that day. There was a tussle. There was a fight. So that day, the fishes refused to come because of the fight. The fight was so terrible. He was trying to catch the fishes. The fishes ran away. God was ordering the fishes to obey the script. So the fishes disappeared. He struggled and struggled and struggled. Jesus had to come back to deliver him. Jesus came and began to cook some fish in front of the ocean. I was cooking the fish. And then they toiled and toiled all night. They could not catch fish. And Jesus shouted and called, "Children, have you any meat?" Somebody told Peter, that is the voice of Jesus. That is his voice. Didn't you see? When Peter said, "Hey," Peter jumped into the river because he was not wearing clothes. And then he swam to the shore. He was not trembling, looking for trousers to wear. And he was not shaking like that. And Jesus said, "Oh yeah, everybody come and eat." They all gathered to eat. They were all trembling. Jesus had to come back to convert them from acting the devil script. The Bible said Jesus looked at Peter and said, "Do you love me more than this?" Peter said, "I love you." Jesus said, You love me where? You are already removing your clothes. You are the sea. Acting the script of the devil. I am bringing you back now. He said, "I love you." Jesus said, "Okay, your duty is feed my sheep." Jesus called again the second time. "Peter, do you love me?" Jesus had to ask him 3 times because he denied Jesus 3 times. As he was denying Jesus, he was signing on the negative script. So Jesus had to make him turn back the positive script, converting him back. And then that was how Peter was converted back to order. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says again in 2 Samuel 15, verse 31. See, men can also help you act the devil's scripts. Yes. There's a way you could move. Men have authority. Use the authority to make you act a devil's script. So also men of God can also help you act God's script. There are places I got to, and the anointing came on me. I said, "Tell this person I've called him." And suddenly an anointing comes on the person transformed from being an ordinary person to a man of God. Acting divine script. Excuse me. Many years ago I came and I was preaching in the Redeemed Christian Church of God Solution Center. And I saw Pastor Ian. Man of God came to me and said, "This man is a businessman." And I pointed and I said, "Sir, I'm hearing that in my right ears here that you're a businessman." And the anointing came on him. He fell on the anointing, got up. That was the day they moved into his original script. Suddenly, a few months later, they told him, "It's either you resign from Microsoft or we sack you." He came to me and said, "Resign before they sack you. Ask them to load you with some serious package." He obeyed me. He told them, "You are going to give me a package. I'm resigning." He resigned. They gave him the package. He came back. We went to Uganda to bury his meeting. While we were praying, God said, "It is time for him to move to South Africa." The anointing came on him. He packed his bag, moved to South Africa, and began to prosper in that land that became a major man. You are living a prophesied life, a prophetic direction, a prophetic lifting. Lifted him there and put him there. He became blessed. He became the one that God is using now to touch many lives. Why? A prophesied life. That anointing came to reroute him back to his script for him to become who he should become. May God send men who are loaded to reroute you. In the name of Jesus Christ. And he's well rooted. He now rerouted other destinies now. Affected them positively. Making sure their lives are set. Why? Because he connected himself. Oh, glory to Jesus Christ. When you connect yourself and the hand of God rests upon you, you can be rerouted. In case you have finished your tenure in a place, God can root you so that you remain constantly on the right book. Not now fulfilling the wrong things. Let me show you this. In the Bible, says in 2 Samuel 15, verse number 31. 2 Samuel 15, 31, the Bible says, "And one told David, saying, Ahithophel is among the conspirators with Absalom. And David said, Oh Lord, I pray thee, turn the counsel of Ahithophel into foolishness." David rerouted this guy. He joined. some team to attack David, and David used his authority to reroute him. Reroute him to another book. Reroute him. Now the Bible says in 2 Samuel 16 verse 23, 2 Samuel 16 23, the Bible says in 2 Samuel 16 23, and the counsel of Ahithophel, which he counseled in those days, was as if a man had inquired of the oracle of God. So was all the counsel of Ahithophel, both with David and with Absalom. This guy had a sharp destiny written in the book of life. He was an oracle of God in counsel, not in prophecy, counsel. His counsel was like somebody who consulted God and came to deliver. That's what the Bible says here. But one day he joined a group to fulfill a negative script in the life of David, and David rerouted him permanently. Be careful who you are attacking, because if the card of you can reroute him. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. A certain lady ran to me. I remember I shared that story severally. And came to me in church and said to me, "Daddy, pray for me." I said, "Daddy, what happened to you? Pray for me, oh, pray for me." But I said, "What happened?" She said she went to a certain prophet. The prophet said, "Give me money." She sowed seed into the life of the prophet. And then the prophet said, "Okay, fine, you are blessed." Yeah. Another time again, she went again. The prophet said, "I sow some seed again." She sowed. She kept on sowing. One day the prophet said, "What's this amount of seed?" She didn't have it. She said, the prophet said, "If you don't sow it, you will die. Some people will befall you." And this prophet began to reroute her destiny. She said, the prophet said, "You'll be sick." She said, immediately fever came on her and she began to shiver. She didn't have the money. She ran away and started running to where I am and said, "You're my dad." I said, "How? But you were giving the money to that prophet and the prophet was rerouting your destiny. Now I'm jammed rock." So she knelt down. Then I rerouted her destiny back by prophecy to the original place and disconnected her from the prophet, that demonic prophet. Hear me clearly. There are people you can connect to and they will reroute your destiny and put you in the place where you'll be fulfilling a demonic destiny. You don't find yourself fulfilling a demonic destiny. The Bible says in 2 Samuel chapter 17 verse 14 verse number 3. 17 verse 14 and verse 20 says, "And all the men of Israel said, the counsel of Hushai the Archite is better than the counsel of Ahithophel. For the Lord had appointed to defeat the good counsel of Ahithophel to the intent that the Lord might bring evil upon Absalom." When David prayed, God answered the prayer. The Bible says in verse number 23, when Ahithophel saw that his counsel was not followed, he saddled his ass and arose and got him home to his house, to his city, and put his household in order, and hanged himself and died, and was buried in the sepulcher of his father. Now listen carefully. A man who was an oracle of God, who speaks as if never, could God have said that he should hang himself? No. He acted another script. Could God have said Ahithophel should hang himself? Never. Ahithophel switched to another script. The day he entered the camp of Absalom and betrayed David, he started acting another script. When David fired prayer into his life, David sealed it, and then foolishness entered him. And it was foolishness that helped him to go and hang himself. Oh, glory to Jesus. Joshua, in Joshua chapter 6, verse 26. Joshua chapter 6, verse number 26. The Bible says something very serious. Joshua 6:26. "And Joshua adjured them at that time, saying, cursed be the man before that rises in this city, Jericho. You shall lay it. And his youngest son shall he set up the gate." So a word was hanging. Whoever touches this gate, his destiny will be rerouted. Whoever comes to this gate to rebuild it will have a rerouting of destiny. He will start acting from scripts. This man, the Bible says in 1 Kings 16:34, concerning a certain man, did he the better like build Jericho. This man was blessed. The anointing was working on him. God was promoting him. He was a rich man. But one day, he decided to go and build Jericho and also build the gate. As soon as he got to the gate, his destiny, that the rerouting started immediately. A a configuration that was around that gate, reconfigured him. The Bible says to us, he laid the foundation thereof in Abiram, his firstborn, and set up the gates thereof in the youngest son, Segob, according to the word of the Lord, which is spoken by Joshua. See a script here. He acted out the script. As soon as they touched the gate, they rerouted his destiny to start fulfilling another script that he never planned to fulfill. Oh, glory to God. That is why you need to be strong as a Christian, so that anywhere you get to, they do not colonize you to start fulfilling the negative scripts. Everywhere you get to, there are books and books. It is the strength and stamina you have in it. That means the script you play. I'm telling you. It is the strength and stamina you have in the spirit realm that determines the script you play. May God help you to play the right script. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, whoever God has sent me to today, may God help you to play the right script. In the name of Jesus Christ, wherever you are, may God help you to play the right script. In the name of Jesus Christ, wherever you are, may God help you to play the right script. You will play the right script. You will not play demonic script. You will not be the one acting the demonic side of destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ, even if they say somebody must be killed, must it be you that will kill the person? Even if they say somebody must be destroyed, must it be you that will be the agent of destruction? Must it be you? May God help you to always play the right script in your marriage, play the right script in the church, play the right script in the presence of God. May God help you to play the right script in the name of Jesus Christ. Every demonic script hanging over your life, I declare them destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Anyone, anywhere, acting the wrong script, I decree the Almighty God sets you free in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive power to start acting the right script from today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In conclusion, everyone has a minimum of two books written concerning the minimum. Books and book. This one is plenty, so let's group them together. Book of lying, book of cheating, book of being a fool, book of fornication, book, books. And then there's a book of life written concerning your life. At every time you are playing out what is written in either of the books, every time. Every time you are either playing from any of the books, whatever you are doing, either of the books,
either the book of life or the books.
Point number three, I'm giving you some conclusions that I came to. Number three, everything you do is a fulfillment of prophecy, either positively or negatively. Everything you do is a fulfillment of prophecy, either positively or negatively. You are either fulfilling prophecy. Everything you are doing, sir, you have been wicked, you are fulfilling prophecy. You have been a thief, you are fulfilling prophecy. You have been adding value, you are fulfilling prophecy. You are teaching others how to do good, you are fulfilling prophecy. You are preaching, you are fulfilling prophecy. Everything, either positively or negatively, that you are doing is a fulfillment of prophecy. You are playing out a script written, sir. Everything. So watch what you are doing. Watch it. Number four. Through prayers, through righteousness, and dogged obedience to God, you can maintain the fulfillment of the positive prophecy. Dogged obedience to God. Dogged obedience to God. Assistance of grace. You can maintain the fulfillment of positive prophecy. Do you know that if you decide to backslide today, you'll be a lesson to others not to backslide. God will bring out something good from your life. People say, like this guy backslided. I will not backslide like that in Jesus' name. Tofia kwa. They will laugh. If you also prosper to tomorrow, people will say, Father, help me to be like this guy. The way you bless him, bless me. I'm telling you, God will always pull out the lesson from your life, sir. So choose to fulfill a positive prophecy. In this church, in this ministry, wherever you are hearing from, choose to fulfill a positive prophecy. Don't be the one coming to attack to make this not to work. It will be on record you are fulfilling a demonic prophecy that world changers will be attacked, but he attacked through you. The Bible says, Jesus said, yes, the Son of Man will be betrayed and sold into wicked hands and they will crucify him. He said, but woe to him through whom he will be sold. He didn't mention anybody's name. Whoever it is, woe. So the devil chose Judas, so woe can betide him. Woe to him. Even if they wrote and said, what changes will pass through shaking? Must you be the one shaking us? Must you be the agent of the devil that must be used? Even if they wrote that your mother will die of accident, must it be you that will connect her to the accident? Must it be you? May God deliver you. and deliver everyone that is acting a negative script in your life also, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Again, number five, but by carelessness and prayerlessness, you can derail and find yourself fulfilling the negative script, becoming a vessel of dishonor. When you are careless, you stop praying, you stop reading the Bible, you stop connected to the work and the will of God. You are just doing whatever you want. I'm okay, Jerry. Let us just see what can happen with you. By carelessness and prayerlessness, Peter became careless at some point because Jesus said, flesh and blood have not revealed this to you, but my Father which is in heaven. And you are Peter, upon this rock I'll build my church. The gates of hell shall not prevail. As soon as that word came, Peter said, yeah, the gates of hell cannot prevail against me. And he began to swell up and down. The devil entered immediately and began to use him. He said, I have the keys of the kingdom of God. They've given it to me already. And upon me, the church will be built. And then the devil entered to finish him so that the gates of hell wants to prevail. The devil chose him, selected him.
Why? Because of the prophecy of his life, that he is the one that will be the bishop of the church. So the devil said, let me also make him the bishop of hell. And began to configure him to fit into it. He became careless. But Jesus caught up with him, told him, he had already sowed the seed, but when you are converted, and the prayer of Jesus worked, he was finally converted. But nobody prayed for Judas. Judas was not too close to be prayed for. He was not too useful. He was just everywhere, pretending, hiding. When service is on, he will not come. He comes late to service so that Jesus will not call him to order. Before service closes, he had disappeared to the Pharisees' service. And then he will come and collect the offering from Philip or James, and then calculate the account. Then he will text Jesus on WhatsApp that this is the account. And then he will shut down his phone so that Jesus can't get him, so that he can attend the Sadducees meeting. Then after he attends the Sadducees meeting, he will open his phone again. All text message will enter. He will shut his phone again so he can read all the text message. Then he chooses who to reply. Every matter that concerns Jesus, hold yourself, hold yourself. I also have other leaders. You are not the only leader on earth until he perished. So who should have prayed for him was not opportune to pray for him. Who should have helped him was not opportune to help him. Why? Because he blocked him, since he had ulterior motives. They planted it and the thing started growing and started making him dodgy, started making him a pretender, started making him hide. When Jesus is coming through this door, Judas is going out through the other door. But then they will call Philip and say, hey, how much is your offering? And then they will record it. And bring to give it to James. Let James bring for me. And so James will bring it to his house. He said, I was very busy. I was doing some business, you know, because he needed to go to the Sanhedrin's meeting. And he was conferring here and there. Because he was not faithful, the devil caught up with him and used him seriously, used him mightily until woe betide him. Again, the Bible talked about many things. Now, let me concentrate on the points and not go again this way so that I can wind up. Now, beware. Beware so you do not keep fulfilling demonic prophecies. Each day before you sleep, ask yourself, which prophecy did I fulfill today? Demonic prophecies or divine prophecies? Check. Ask yourself. Ask yourself. Do you know whatever you do on earth is a seed? It has consequences on earth. And also, it has harvest hereafter. Everything you do is a seed. It has consequences on earth here before you leave. And then it has harvest hereafter. Watch out for what people say into your life, because they are verbalizing the books. When somebody look at you and say, you are, in fact, you are brought shame. You are shame on you, and you keep quiet. Child, they are prophesying that you bring in shame. They are verbalizing demonic prophecy. So also, when somebody looks at you and says, you will make it, in the name of Jesus, it is also verbalization of the prophecies in the book. Because the Bible has given power to men to bless. Hallelujah. Praise God. So be careful what people are saying into your life. Be careful what you also do to trigger what people say. Don't go and trigger negative things, because it was a causeless causes shall not come. So it was Ahithophel that provoked what David said, and he shifted from the right script of being an oracle to being a suicidal fellow immediately. So be careful what you do, so you do not open the door for people to reconfigure your destiny with their statements. But if somebody is doing that
without a cause, it will not work. I stand as a priest over this altar, and I speak over your life that every word spoken over you negatively will never prosper. It will never prosper. It will never prosper. It will never prosper. It will never prosper. In the name of Jesus Christ, every word spoken, I don't care who spoke it, but I stand as your own priest and I cancel it. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You can prayerfully abolish the fulfillment of demonic prophecies in your life. If you have noticed that there's a certain trend that is negative, prayerfully abolish it. Jesus told Peter, I have prayed for you. So with prayer, we can move you back to the right book and cause you to fulfill the right prophecy. Hallelujah. I have prayed for you. I have prayed for you. Jesus told Peter, I have prayed. So prayer can move you back to the right script. Hallelujah. Praise God. Oh, glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Always provoke positive prophecies daily by inspiring your prophet positively. Always provoke positive prophecy daily. Provoke it. I do that regularly. I provoke my spiritual father and he blesses me, sir. I provoke all my mentors and my governors and they bless me. Always provoke it. The Bible says, Isaac said, get me venison, the kind I love. Get me savory meat so I can eat it and my soul will bless you. Always provide savory meat that will make the prophet bless you, sir, so that you can remain on track. A life that is devoid of blessing will soon derail. It takes blessing to keep you constantly on the rail. It takes blessing to keep you constantly on the move. May God bless you wherever you are. I decree, may heaven bless you. May God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessings keep you permanently on track. Makes it difficult for you to derail. Always provoke it. Provoke it. Do things that, you are blessed. May God bless you. Do such things. Don't do things that somebody will look at you and say, yeah, you did this to me. May God judge you. That's what is dangerous. They are playing at a script, trying to reprogram you to the demonic script. So be careful. Hallelujah. Praise God. Deny the devil the chance of making you a vessel unto dishonor. Deny him. Deny him that chance. Don't allow it happen to you. Don't be a saboteur. Don't be deceptive. Don't be dubious. Follow the 10 tenets of this ministry that is announced and publicized everywhere. Be always walk in unity, walk in purity, walk in dignity, walk in honesty, humility. Be responsible. Don't be an irresponsible person. Be magnanimous. Be reliable. Don't be an unreliable person. Be full of integrity. Be sincere. All glory to Jesus Christ. Be sincere. Serve God with integrity, sir. Deny the devil the chance to make you part of those played from his scripts. Deny him that chance by keeping yourself on track, making up your mind, I will never do this no matter what happens. I will never go this way. Forget it. And the Lord God Almighty will honor you. Command the fire of the Holy Ghost to consume the content of every demonic prophecy concerning your life. Command fire to consume it. I will never fulfill it. Wherever you are, I want you to begin to pray right now. I refuse to fulfill demonic prophecy in my life. I will never fulfill demonic prophecy. Every demonic prophecy hanging all over around my destiny, you are a failure. I will never fulfill you. Etukete kebregedusha, mazonte likatusha. World changers will never fulfill demonic prophecy. This church will never fulfill demonic prophecy. Lord, I decree our members will never fulfill demonic prophecy. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every demonic prophecy, organized, orchestrated, and arranged, written in any book, released so that we can now begin to walk by it, I command it to catch fire. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, keep me on track. God, keep all the ministers here on track in the name of Jesus Christ. Keep us on track, oh God. Keep all the members on track, whether they are here or they are still online. Lord, keep them on track. They will not obey demonic dictates. Their destinies will not be thwarted. They will not be sifted like wheat in the name of Jesus Christ. No member of this church will be used by the devil to fulfill a demonic prophecy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But adventure, there are already some on that path already. Lord, move them back, oh Lord God, to the right path. Switch them back to the right book. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let them fulfill the right script authority in the name of Jesus. Lord, I command fire to consume every evil prophetic book written concerning anyone, written that they be thieves, written that they become fornicators, written that they become adulterers. I command that book consumed by fire, consumed by fire, consumed by fire. You will not prosper in the name of Jesus. I set those books on fire. In this area, world changers is exalted by the glory of God, that all men might come to serve God with us in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil book written against us, we will never fulfill you. It will not prosper in the name of Jesus Christ. We say ke legedege bregedusha man degedege bregedusha gaduse ikologodogodogodosegadata oria kalaga bagalaba. Lord, I refuse to fulfill every demonic script in the name of Jesus Christ. On degedege bregedusegada oria kalaga daga bregedusegada ikologodogodogodosegadata ikalegedege bregedusegada ore kalaga daga bregedusegadugaba oria kalaga daba. Every statement that I moved somebody to begin to fulfill demonic prophecy, I cancel it now. I cancel it now in the name of Jesus Christ. I decree to not see the light of the day in the name of Jesus Christ. Every member of this church fulfills the right script in the name of Jesus Christ. Let it be so, oh God. Thank you, Father. We know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. Immortal God, I have brought your word fresh from the kitchen of heaven, feeding your flock that you sent me to. They have listened to your word. I ask today, oh God, anyone already at the other side fulfilling demonic script, move them back right now to fulfill divine script. The way you helped Peter and you reprogrammed him back to fulfill the right script, I reprogram them back to fulfill the right script. And I command every demonic script written concerning them, catch fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Nobody here, including myself, will fulfill a demonic script in the name of Jesus Christ. We shall fulfill the right script today in the name of Jesus Christ. We know, oh Lord God, that everything we do is a fulfillment of prophecy. We decree that we shall fulfill the right prophecy, not a demonic or a negative prophecy like Judas, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lay your hands upon us, oh God. Give us understanding of this message in a clearer dimension, so that from this day henceforth we will deliberately, prayerfully, in righteousness, with dogged obedience, stick to the book of life. Thank you, Father. We know it is done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You are living a prophesied life. Whatever you are, get out your offerings right now. It's time to give. If you are in East Africa, you can use the M-Pesa pay bill. If you are outside East Africa or any part of the world, you can still use M-Pesa, M-Pesa by going on SendWave. If you get the app called SendWave, you can send your offering straight using the phone number on the screen. It will hit the place straight. It will get down here. My phone number is on the screen. And then if you're in East Africa, use the pay bill 821430. The thing will hit the account straight.
And the Lord God Almighty will bless you.
I decree your wealth will not fulfill the negative script
in the name of Jesus Christ.
If it is your tithe, I release the anointing upon your tithe. If it's your seed for the building that is going on, the Lord God Almighty bless you mightily from wherever you are sending the seed from. It is well accepted and well received. Don't hold back. If you hold back, you are fulfilling the script. You refuse to pay your tithe, you are fulfilling the script of poverty. Don't hold back. Make sure you release it so you can fulfill the right script. I release the anointing upon every giver and upon their offerings. As you send in your offering right now, the Almighty God receives it. I decree it will make your life better. It will maintain you on the right script. In the name of Jesus Christ, no evil will befall you. The favor of God is upon you. You will do well in all areas of life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare you blessed. Your wealth is blessed. I decree every work of your hand is also blessed. In the name of Jesus Christ, so shall it be. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. In the next 1 hour plus, 1 hour thereabout, we shall be on again for the second service. In the second service, we shall be programming this month of May. We shall be commanding the mornings
of the month of May.
Please make sure you are connected for that. And in the evening, we will go back to our teaching on how to position ourselves in this global new dawn positively. In this global new dawn, we've had already 2 days and it's been powerful. And then by the grace of God, this evening, By 7:30 p.m. again, we shall be on. The Lord God Almighty bless you
as you connect with us in the name of Jesus Christ.
All right, we want to thank God for all those who joined us from different parts of the world. The Lord God Almighty bless you. Life Eternal Development Church, thank you for joining us. The whole church joining us. The Lord bless you. Thank you for joining us. Moses Karuanda, God bless you mightily in the name of Jesus and cause his face to shine upon you. May you fulfill the right script and not a demonic script in Jesus' name. DK Bet, the Lord bless you. Thank you for joining us. The Lord bless you and cause you to fulfill the right script. Jesse Konditi, the Lord bless you, son. Thank you for joining us. The Almighty God cause you to fulfill the right script. Pastor Grace Israel Okere, thank you for joining us. The Lord bless you mightily in the name of Jesus. Julius Dela Noil, the Lord bless you. Thank you for joining us mightily in the name of Jesus Christ. All right. Now, okay, people have made comments. Bembo Owuko, the Lord bless you. Thank you for joining us. Susan Kirima, thank you for joining us. The Lord bless you and cause you all to fulfill a divine script in the name of Jesus. Dorcas Chepiatich, the Lord bless you. Thank you for joining us. Miriam Mbuli, thank you for joining us. The Lord bless you. May you fulfill the right script, the script of Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. Nyaruai Helena, thank you for joining us. The Lord bless you mightily. You will fulfill divine script. You will not fulfill the script of the devil even for a minute, in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord bless everyone who are joined. In case I did not mention you, it means you did not make a comment or something. But I can see that you're online. The Lord God Almighty bless. I can see a number, not your name or something. Those I've seen, their names I've mentioned. The Lord bless you. Have a wonderful afternoon. Bye-bye. God bless you. See you in 1 hour time. God bless you.